you and welcome to Adelante Chicago. I'm Lourdes Duarte. We begin with the battle that many parents are fighting to keep their kids safe from ongoing violence on Chicago streets. A group of parents is raising awareness about the problem, and they want you to get involved. Joining us to explain are Robert Torres. He's the executive director and co-founder of Parents for Peace and Justice. Also, Lourdes Lara and Milagros Burgos, who are members of this organization. We appreciate your time. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you. Thank you for having us.
Okay, I want to start with Parents for Peace and Justice, how it started, why, and what you're doing today.
Sure. So it started off with about 11 years ago where there was a mother just posting on social media. And after 3 days, I was just compelled to reach out to her. And I remember as I reached out to her and said, how can I help? We literally just went to work and we started to do visuals in the community and whatnot, but we learned a lot in that community, right? The need and the lack of. And so we just went to work and we started to help moms affected the gun violence and started to have programming, and that's how Parents for Peace and Justice was born.
And here you are now 11 years later, which we have seen the crime issues in the city of Chicago really evolve.
Yes.
Through the years, where our minority communities, it seems like they're being hit really specifically difficult times right now.
Absolutely. It's and we live in the Belmont Creighton community where the act of violence was also unfortunately took place for these two beautiful mothers. And we're trying to fight and make sure that people don't forget about our community as well. We are now, it's moved up west, so the Belmont Creighton has become the new Humboldt Park in terms of violence. And so we're fighting very hard, along with these beautiful mothers that are also a voice for their children and for the families also in the community. Yeah. So we're doing a lot of work.
And we'll talk about some of the different programs that you've put in place, but I want to bring in these two mothers because I'm sure you have unbelievable stories about what has happened. Lourdes, I'll start with you. Talk about your experience and what happened in your son's case.
My son, he was the member of the National Guard in July 3rd. He was murdered in Belmont Crane. Our case, we have evidence with three witnesses. Evidence that it was not enough for the state attorney to press charges. One of the witness, he pointed out the shooter, and it was not enough for the state attorney. In 9 months, with 2 weeks, we haven't had justice for my son.
So the idea behind what you're doing as part of this organization, it's not just to build awareness about the crime issues that we're seeing in the city, but to also work with families and parents as they move along through the process if they do want to get justice for their families and their kids.
Yes, I know nothing that we can do. I'm going to bring my son back. But I don't want any young man like my son to lose his dreams and another family, another mother sitting in this chair talking about any children.
So you're hoping that through his life and his story, it brings about some change?
Yes, hope and peace for our community and hope for our children.
What has it been like for you to work with some of these parents? Because in essence, you're talking about families that are all going through the exact same thing, right?
Well, for me, it brings comfort because I feel that in the city of Chicago, or any city, no family should be going through the trauma every day that we go through. And if we could share our voices for prevention and awareness, I think that's making a step forward. My daughter's life counted like so many other lives that were taken from gun violence.
And talk a little bit about your daughter. I know you started a scholarship in her name, in her honor, but bring us back to the time when she was killed and passed away.
Unfortunately, my daughter's life was taken on October 19, 2014. She was picking up her younger brother as they were very close. And we had gone to the theater, my husband and I, and she had gone the day before to see one of her best friends at Second City, one of her first performance. So on the next day where my daughter went to work, she worked full-time and part-time, and she worked full-time She was a student full-time,
And worked part-time.
Worked part-time. She also worked for the Chicago Park District part-time in the summertime, mm-hmm. so she loved working with children. Fortunately, that day was the worst day of our lives when we got that phone call. No family should even experience the trauma of getting a phone call of your son telling you that your daughter was shot or his sister was shot or anyone in the family that was shot.
Do you feel like in her case you were able to get some justice and find the person responsible?
No, our case is still unsolved. We do live north. And it happened in the bomb on Cragen, but it doesn't matter where it happens. It doesn't matter who you are. It doesn't matter your background. I think all cases should be taken delicately and in the same manner. My daughter had a whole future ahead of her. She had dreams and goals that she expected to live just like us as parents. We never in a million years would have thought that something like that would have happened to her or anyone that we knew. Yeah. And when that happened, it seemed like I met another person that I knew in high school that it happened to her son. And it's just a constant trauma that continuing happen, and it shouldn't, because it's preventable. Gun violence is preventable.
It's very sad, and when I see you two come together and speak here, I think it serves as a way to raise awareness for so many other parents who may be dealing with the same thing. As you look at the numbers of families that are going through this, how many parents have now joined the group and are dealing with the exact same thing? Because I know it's not just the two of them.
Yeah. To put it in perspective, we have three large tables that we've run out of space for pictures. So when we have our support groups, it literally just tuggles our heart. And we're trying to do everything in our power with our programs to help these moms, rather be counseling and therapy, a workshop for them, or a support group meeting. It's all needed because these mothers' trauma and pain is alive and well, mm-hmm. and so we need to address that. And that's what we want to remind, is what the act of violence, what it does, and the trauma, the effect that it has, not only them, but the whole city of Chicago, because it affects us all.
Okay. You've got an interesting program that you're working on now, which you want to bring in mental health into the elementary schools. Tell me how that's going, and when do you think it'll be taking off?
So we're working right now with one of the elementary schools in our community. And so we're going to be bringing a mental health program into the community, along with partnerships with Governor State University. We're going to start there. We're going to perfect that, because we've learned by listening to these teachers and principals that as early as fourth grade, and fourth grade is when we're starting to see the problem. We want to do that and take that across our community and across the city, hopefully. So
think about that. Fourth grade, a kid who's 10 years old getting into trouble.
So. Correct.
Okay, thank you very much, Parents for Peace and Justice. If folks want to communicate with you, what's the best way to do it?
They can contact us through our either
website,
email or website. That's www.parentsforpeaceandjustice.org. Or you can email us as well as parentsforpeaceandjustice@gmail.com.
All right, and we will post that information on our Facebook page here for Adelante Chicago. Thank you to all three of you
for
coming in today. This is an important topic.